A ball drops on a horizontal surface and bounces elastically. So like boing, boing, and then go up again. What happens to the kinetic energy of the ball during the very short time it is in contact with the surface? I'm not looking when the ball is flying. I'm saying when the ball is touching the surface, what is happening to the kinetic energy? If you haven't tried this question, I encourage you to pause the video and think carefully through the choices. Which one would you choose? Let's draw out a picture to kind of think a little bit more carefully of what is happening when you have a ball hitting on the surface. So I'm going to do an animation. At first, the ball is coming down towards the floor. Then it will hit the floor. Then it's bouncing elastically. So what's going to happen probably is this ball will go boing, boing, flatten, and then it goes kind of in shape again, and it is ready to take off, and it will go up. So the time that we are looking at is the time where it is in contact. So we are looking at from here all the way until this moment in time. What happened to the KE? Is it miss got KE meh? Go on, you start off with the kinetic energy and you are moving. So the moment you touch, you are moving at a very fast kinetic energy downwards. The moment you are just about to leave, you have a lot of kinetic energy upwards. Of course, here also got la, down and up. So in between, something has to happen. Eventually, you have no KE at all. Where did the energy go? Elastic. Does that ring a bell? Elastic. So actually what happens is there's elastic potential energy happening here. The boing boing ball became a spring, and you kind of like squash the spring, and then the spring come out again. So let's look at the choices. Most of the KE is lost as heat and sound. Heat and sound. Potentially true. Potentially. When there's a collision, when you go boing boing, the ball actually gets hot because you are compressing the atomic structure inside the ball and all that kind of stuff. And there could be some sound when you go boing. But okay, maybe it's correct. Well, let's continue and look at the rest first. B says, the kinetic energy decreased to zero and returned to original value. Oh, this was what I was just talking about. KE, not moving, KE up. So in the process in between, you have to have some KE zero. So this one looks more correct. Let's check C. The KE remains constant because it is an elastic collision. No, the KE is not constant all the way. Although the initial KE, let's say it's 2 joule, will be exactly the same as the final KE after. That is definition of elastic collision, correct? But we are looking at what happens during the time where it's in contact with the surface. So, no. D says the KE is constant in magnitude but changes direction. Nani. Wait. KE does not have direction. Let me make that very clear. Kinetic energy and basically all kinds of energy is a scalar. Scalar does not have direction one. You don't say things like 5 joules to the left, 5 joules to the right, 5 joules upwards, 10 joules downwards. No. KE energy itself is a scalar. Although it is linked to forces, which is a vector. So, no. So that leaves us with A and B. Most kinetic energy is lost as heat and sound. Well, yes, some kinetic energy is lost, but here we are looking at the elastic collision. There should not be any energy loss from initial to final. So this would be true if not an elastic collision or interaction between the ball and the surface. So yes, in real life, that would be true. But in this case, we're looking at the elastic, perfectly elastic collision, I guess. So that would be B, would be the best choice between A and B. Okay, so think carefully of things going boing boing and collisions. But that's all for this video. I'll see you in the next one.